Yeah, I was not aware of the provisional status. People in the Baltimore City Fire Department were.
But how is that possible? I mean, you're in charge.
Well, that's one of the issues that the investigation turned up, was that the communication between the Fire Academy staff and up the chain of command didn't happen. And that's a problem that, you know, we've acknowledged that we stumbled on. In addition, MIMS had turnover of the personnel that sent the letters in 2010. And during the year intervening, there was never any attempt from MIMS until April of 2011 to notify me or anybody else in the leadership of the department that they had indeed not received the reports that they needed or the information that they needed to maintain our status. So I think there was a breakdown in communications, definitely in the fire department, and certainly in between us and MIMS.
This seems like it's a serious issue that, I mean, could be affected by a communications breakdown. I mean, it has to deal with a certification of your program, and it's not a minor matter. Doesn't that raise some red flags here?
Well, I think it does, and I think the actions we took when I got the letter last month reflect the serious nature of it. But I will say, in addition, that nobody is providing service that's not certified. Everyone's getting the recertification they need. All the classes that were in progress at the time we got the letter from MIMS were allowed to continue. MIMS continues to test our firefighters that were already in class. And so the effect, the practical effect on the ground, is not drastic yet. Our challenge now is to get relationships solidified with other agencies so that this training is ongoing. We don't have a break in the recertification process, because that is going on all year round.
Who does MIMS normally correspond with in terms of problems with the training academy? You or the training academy?
Directly with the training academy. They work directly with the officer in charge of the EMS side of the training academy.
So it wasn't an unusual procedure for them to correspond with them. It was just unusual that no one told you?
Right. It was unusual that it didn't come up through the chain of command. Now, the issues they identified were not insurmountable. In fact, they were relatively minor. They were paperwork issues, and we had one issues with preceptors that I was aware that MIMS was concerned about. The issue of preceptors had been worked on since the spring, and I was brought several plans to increase the number of preceptors. And that was in place, and MIMS is acknowledging in the letters that was addressed. The other three issues were primarily paperwork, and they're important, but they don't go directly to whether or not a firefighter or a paramedic is able to do the job on the street.